Hey guys, how's it going? I've never done a channel update video, but I figured this is probably a very good time to do it for two reasons. One, I am just about to hit 50,000 subscribers, which I cannot even comprehend how many people that is. I think there's enough of you to fill up an entire football stadium, which is just absolutely mind-blowing to me. And my second reason for making this video is the league project, which I've spent almost a year on, has finally concluded. If you haven't seen the video, be sure to go give it a watch. But to start things off, I feel like I owe you guys an explanation as to why there's been so few uploads on my channel and why those uploads have been about a temporary game mode that took place 11 months ago. So, story time with Ingus. Are we ready? Okay. So this story starts with my last upload of the year, last year, which was the nightmare video. I had no idea that that video was going to be as successful as it went on to be, which I think in the first, like say week or so, it hit 200K views, which is just absolutely crazy to think about, especially for my channel, because I've never had a video do that before. Having that video do so well was amazing. It's what I've been working for, you know, since I started this channel, to create something so cool that a lot of people enjoy. I don't know what it is, but after that video, like, I just developed this feeling of paralysis. And the follow-up to that video had to be even better than that one, because that was my whole mindset. You know, that's been my mindset for my entire career of YouTube, has been to always make a video that's better than the last one. And so far it worked out. You know, if you go to my very first videos and then you compare to my most recent videos, like, there are worlds apart. I've learned so much as a YouTuber. The thing about trying to improve yourself every time is that it gets exhausting after a while. It really does. And I never gave myself a break to just be like, okay, you know, I'll just make like, yeah, I'll just, I won't try as hard on this video. No, pretty much every video I've made on this channel so far has always been about how can I make it better than that? So that's always been my mindset from day one. But when I made this nightmare video, I honestly felt like, how do I even top this? I wasn't sure how to top it. You know, I just finished a very long series that took me 8 months to make, the Dreamview series. And yeah, I know this is a really weird reaction to achieving success. And you're probably thinking, wow, this guy is just like a schmuck. But this is just how I was thinking, dude. I know now I was overthinking it, but you know, at the time that was my mindset. And then I received the Trailblazer League challenge. When I received this challenge, you know, my mind was very much in this framework of wanting to do better. So when I accepted this challenge, you know, I told myself that I had to make one single video out of this entire Trailblazer League experience. So one of the downsides of that is that I would not be able to upload for 2 months, which I was fine with because I had gone on for, you know, 1 month, 2 months, 2.5 months before to record some stuff for the Dreamview series. You know, it took a while to make some of those videos. I was fine with that. I was like, yeah, I'll just record for 2 months, you know, no problem. But I didn't expect myself to go as hard as I did. Keep in mind, this is also in the rebound of COVID when that happened. You know, it was last winter. I don't know if you guys remember last winter, but for me personally, it was a very dark time, just in general, you know, with the whole world. I'm not going to spoil what happened in those videos, but if you know, you know. So eventually, 2 months later, the league concludes, and now it is my turn to edit all 1.6 terabytes of footage into one video. Now, the nightmare video was not even close to that. It's a lot of recording the ends of kills. I might have a bunch of, you know, 30 second clips or whatever for each kill, but it does not add up to 1.6 terabytes. I did not account for the amount of different stuff that happens throughout a new account to the end of account. So January 6th rolls around, the league ends, and I am completely just burnt out from the league. I'm completely burnt out. And so I decide I need to take a long break and then I'll get back to editing, which I did. You know, a few weeks go by and finally, you know, I'm ready to edit. It's now February 1st or so. And as I begin editing, I experienced a ton of technical issues with the raw footage. I remember that being so demotivating because here I had this massive amount of footage that I needed to go through, and it was just completely destroying my software that I use. Adobe needs to fix their shit. But yeah, it tore everything apart. I even upgraded my computer a lot. Yeah, it was bad. Eventually, I figured out a bunch of workaround solutions for that, so that's one thing. And then the second thing is that I discovered Blender at the same time, which I'll probably make a separate video about that journey of my journey of learning 3D animation for old school RuneScape. That's a complete separate journey that we'll be here all day if I have to go into that. So trying to shape that massive amount of footage, like I needed more time for my brain to process like what I needed to do for that. And so I dove into 3D animation to occupy my time, let my brain think, and I got really into it. Let's just say that I got really into it. And of course, I was operating under this framework that this one video had to blow the nightmare video completely out of the water. It had to be amazing. It had to be the greatest thing that I had ever created, which is a lot of pressure to put on yourself. Let me tell you, it is a lot of pressure. If you're an artist, then you probably understand what I'm talking about. So I spent, you know, several months learning animation and piecing this thing together. And quickly I realized that there's no possible way that I can make one video with this. Maybe now I could, but at the time I was not up for the task. It probably would have been 3 hours long and I probably would have lost my shit. And I don't think it would have came out any sooner because I would have put the exact same amount of work into it. So fast forward to about May 1st, and my first video is released. So this is 4 months after the league has ended. Now, when this video came out, I had a lot of great feedback on the animations, which was great because I spent a lot of time learning how to do all that stuff. And the momentum from that carried me into episode 2, which I released in the same month. And things were going really well. It was the end of May. And then, you know, once I finish this, I'll get onto my next projects. But then a few drastic things happened in my life. Not bad. They're not bad at all. So I moved while my wife was 8 months pregnant. Needless to say, it was a lot of work and I was not prepared for that. I got most of my stuff moved in. I was technically working on Dream Gear The Lost Chapter Part 3, but with everything going on, my creativity, I just found just wasn't there to make the last episode, you know, because I wanted it to be a three-parter instead of just one video, because that, you know, three is cool. Up until now, there had been very little updates to the game, so I didn't really feel bad about doing this, you know, because I had been completely burnt out by leagues. But eventually in the summer, you know, Hard Mode Taub comes out, and so I think, you know, okay, I'll take a break from the league video, and I'll make a few shorter videos, and then get back to the league finale. And then July rolls around, and my first baby is born, which has been an absolute amazing thing. I highly recommend, if you ever have the chance, being a father is quite a big change as far as responsibility goes. I've never really thought about that. I knew that it would change my life, but I didn't know how exactly it would feel to be taken care of, not just your partner, but also your child as well. And so this first baby comes around and I wasn't even fully moved in yet. So things were just really hectic this summer. And so that took a few weeks. I also participated in the EVscape Battle Royale, the Rookies Edition. So I spent like a couple weeks doing that, preparing for that with Becht, because I really wanted to win. If you haven't seen it, go watch it. I did place pretty far in it. So once things finally started to settle down and I began production for part 3, I quickly realized that the MaxCape Saga was a very strange place to start on for the final episode. And I literally just couldn't get it to flow right. So I was like, you know what? I'll cut this part off. I'll make it into episode 3. And then, of course, I spent a few months working on episode 4. I designed the entire Sisterhood Sanctuary in Blender. I made it from scratch. So after this massive, nearly year-long journey, I finally completed the Trailblazer League project. My entire goal for this one video, but now it's 4, was to make the best video I could possibly make. And by the second episode, I had to accept that I can try my best to edit and make really cool content, but at the end of the day, I don't get to choose how it performs on the algorithm. If a video doesn't do as well as I had hoped, then, you know, there's nothing I could do about it. The only thing I could do is just try my best every time. It was just me trying to create a very cool concept for a video. A lot of people might say that it's dated footage or whatever, but at the end of the day, I just wanted to improve my skills, learn 3D animation, and I think I accomplished that for the most part. So what did I learn from the Trailblazer League project? Well, my goal since day one has been to make this a full-time endeavor. And honestly, I just have not done a great job at that by going months and months without uploading. this project has taught me that I need to start uploading more if I want this channel to be sustainable. So this is what you're gonna expect on my channel in the coming months. I'm gonna be uploading more. I'm gonna try my best to keep the quality as high as possible, but ultimately I've just had to come to this realization that I cannot spend 2 months on every video. You know, some channels can do it, but I think for now I need to tone it down just a little bit. It doesn't have to be this crazy, like, full-blown movie production every time. I have to humble myself and take that ego down and be like, look, this doesn't have to be the best possible video ever. And honestly, it's gonna be hard to do that for myself, so you're probably still gonna get some really cool videos, but that's not to say I'll never work on a big project again. But after this Trailblazer League saga, I think I need to take it easier just so I can keep this channel alive. So I guess I'll start with the Ingus account, which I have been playing periodically throughout the last year, even though I haven't made very many videos on it. I think I made one or two. I did record a lot of the stuff that I did this year, and I'll probably put that into a video just if you guys wanted to be caught up to speed. Other than that, I don't think I'll be playing this account much until a few updates come out, such as Nex, which was teased last week, and of course Raids 3 early next year. So that's that for this account. Obviously, the big elephant in the room is whether I will be playing Group Iron Man. That is the biggest thing that's going to be happening this year. And I remember watching the RuneFest live stream. Group Iron Man. Look, I remember it vividly. So I do have plans to play it. Once that comes out, you'll be seeing some videos from me on that. I don't want to spoil too much or who I'm with or whatever. And for RuneScape in general, you know, there's a lot of cool stuff coming out that I think I would love to make content about. Like Leagues 3 is coming out. I don't think I'm going to play as much as I did last year. I hope you guys can understand that. Yeah, I think I played enough League last year to play for the next like 4 leagues. So I'm definitely not gonna like go hard at it. And if I do, then you guys need to remind me that I'm gonna lose my YouTube channel if I do. And then like I mentioned, Nex and Raids 3 is also coming out. I don't know what else is planned besides that, but it's a lot to look forward to. So yeah. I think that about wraps this video up. I'll end by saying thank you so much for 50,000 subscribers. I don't know what I'd be doing without this channel, honestly, but all I can say is that I wouldn't trade it for the world. So thanks for being here and supporting what I do. Now, I don't expect anyone to do this because you guys have fully supported all my work thus far, but just for those people who would like to go the extra step, I do have a Patreon, so check that out. The link is in the description. But for now, I think that is it. Thank you guys so much for continuing to support the channel. Thanks for 50,000 subs. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.